Teachers due to all my faculty, starting with my case presentation. Dear old female, resident of Lucknow, presented with chief complaint of swelling in front of neck for last two years. She was apparently all right 2 years back. To start with, she developed a small swelling in front of neck, which gradually increased and attended in the present site. No history of features suggestive of hypothyroidism in the form of weight gain, intolerance to cold or low memory. And no history of features suggestive of hyperthyroidism in the form of increased appetite but weight loss, palpitation, intolerance to heat or difficulty in vision. No history of compressive symptoms in the form of voice change, difficulty in swallowing, difficulty in breathing. No history of bone pain, fracture or jaundice present. Patient has no history of diabetes, hypertension, TB, COPD or asthma. No history of any previous surgery and there was no history of any exposure to any type of radiation. Patient takes mixed diet, her sleep cycle was normal, bowel and bladder habit was normal. She was married for last 7 years and blessed with two children. No history of any addiction to tobacco or alcohol. She has no history of any similar illness like thyroid swelling in any of the family members. Coming to general examination of the patient. Patient is conscious, well oriented to time, place and person. Average body weight, her pulse rate was 78 per minute, normal volume, regular rhythm, no radioradial or no radiofemoral delay. Her BP was 122 by 80 mm mercury, right arm supine position, and there was no pillar, icterus, cyanosis, clubbing or generalized lymphadenopathy noticed. Coming to local examination of neck, on inspection, swelling is present in front of neck in right paratracheal region. It moves with deglutition, uval sepal. Approximately 7 into 5 cm extending horizontally from anterior border of right sternocleidomastoid muscle to 0.5 cm left of midline and vertically from thyroid cartilage to 2 cm above suprasternal notch. Lower border was visible and left lobe and isthmus are normal. On palpation, inspectory findings are confirmed and swelling was non-tender, no local rise of temperature was there. Swelling had smooth surface, firm in consistency, mobility in horizontal direction was present, lower border is palpable. Bilateral carotid artery is palpable and is at normal site. Trachea is central in position and no cervical lymphadenopathy was present. On percussion, no dullness over manubrium sterni present and on auscultation, no bruit was present. Systemic examination, respiratory system, bilateral symmetrical chest movement was present, no tenderness or swelling, bilateral normal vesicular breath sound, no added sound were there. On CBS examination, apex beat was at normal position, no parasternal heave, S1 and S2 was normal, no murmur was found. Abdominal examination, soft, non-tender, no organomegaly and no free fluid was there. On central nervous system examination, higher mental function were normal, no focal deficit was seen. And on musculoskeletal examination, power 5 out of 5 in all limbs with normal tone and deep tendon reflex were normal and there was no bony pain. Coming to summary of the case, 32-year-old lady with thyroid swelling of 2-year duration with no history of compressive symptoms or symptoms associating with hypo or hyperthyroidism. Thyroid swelling had smooth surface, firm in consistency, lower border was palpable, central trachea and no cervical lymphadenopathy was present. So provisional diagnosis was made, right solitary thyroid nodule without any retrosternal extension, which was euthyroid in status and benign in nature. Hematological biochemical investigation were done which was in within normal limit. FT4 was also within normal limit, 17.47. TSH was 1.21. Indirect laryngoscopy was done before operation, which was bilateral vocal cord were mobile. Ultrasound of thyroid, right lobe. The whole lesion was replacing the whole of the right lobe. It was 3.7 cm into 3 cm approximately, hyperechoic to isoechoic, and there were areas of cystic degeneration present. Left lobe size was 1.7 cm into 1.3 cm. Isthmus were normal, and no significant cervical lymphadenopathy was present. This was X-ray. APN lateral neck view. Ephanasy of the lesion done. In ephanasy, clusters of benign follicular epithelial cells, cystic macrophages, background of colloid and hemorrhage, and no malignant cells were found. So after with all these investigation and pre-op data, right hemithyroidectomy was planned, and we underwent right hemithyroidectomy. Patient's cut section, right lobe was 7 cm into 5 cm into 3 cm. Isthmus was 1.5 cm into 1 cm into 1 cm. Weight of the cut specimen was 54 g, and it was well encapsulated nodule in upper part of the right lobe. Cut surface brownish black solid nodules with cystic areas containing brownish fluid and pink fleshy tissue at inferior pole. Histopathology of the specimen was a colloid nodule with cystic degeneration. And post-operative patient, it was uneventful. Early post-op recovery was there. No change in voice, no difficulty in swallowing, and no breathing difficulty patient had. And patient was discharged on post-op day 1. Thank you.